Here at the Pulse, we sometimes go through slumps. And when that happens, it's time to call in the experts.
Look at your posture. There's definitely something wrong there. What do you do with your hands here?
I mean, my posture's good though, isn't it?
Yeah, but your hands are like floating.
Is that bad?
It's not good. When did Harry Houdini become a part of the Pulse?
Eventually, the Grey Ones always figure it out.
I'm embarrassed.
So Julia, you're in the play. Who is your favorite character?
Well, I mean, the old lady in the wheelchair was pretty great, but I also was a really big fan of Moonface Martin.
I really like Billy Crocker, and also the shiny teethings were pretty funny.
Okay, cool. Let's check out this video on other people's favorite fictional characters.
Who's your favorite fictional character?
Patrick Starr?
Nigel Thornberry, that was fun.
My favorite fictional character is SpongeBob. My favorite fictional character is Jerry from Tom and Jerry, because he's a mouse.
My favorite character is Richard Nixon.
Aladdin, because he's magic carpet.
Borat, because he's a boss.
My favorite fictional character is Hannah from Girls.
I gotta go with Mr. Krabs. I gotta get some money for days.
The real question is, who isn't my favorite fictional character? See, such a great reader, I like them all the same.
My favorite fictional character is Scarlett O'Hara from Gone with the Wind, because she was a strong female role model who showed that women could overcome anything.
Kelsey Grinitsky. The way she moves is fictional.
Hannah Montana.
My favorite fictional character is Jack Bauer, because he's awesome. He agrees.
My fictional character is Don Quixote de la Mancha, because represent the dreams, represent the pursuit of happiness.
I would say Mr. Curran, because he is an absolute legend.
My favorite fictional character was the man in the red sweater, Call the Wild.
Harry Potter, because I like how he can do magic.
Harry Potter, because he's a wizard.
Harry Potter, because he's a wizard.
Jar Jar Binks.
R2-D2.
Who is your favorite fictional character and why?
Ron Swanson, because he's a beast.
Ron Swanson, because of his mustache.
Leslie Knope from Parks and Rec.
Jay Gatsby, because he has such a desire for hope and a romantic readiness that makes him ready to believe that anything is possible, and that's phenomenal.
So, Devin, have you read any good books lately?
Well, not really. I'm looking for some suggestions, though.
Well, actually, I heard about this great book called Divergent.
Oh, really? What's it about?
Why don't we check with my friend Kimmy? She knows a lot more about it than I do.
Hi, I'm Kimmy, and I read the book Allegiant, which is the third book in the Divergent series. The first one is Divergent, second one is an Insurgent, and then the third one is Allegiant. And I picked up this book because my friend Megan recommended it to me, and she knows me really well, so she said that I'd really like this book, and so I said, you know, why not? And I picked it up, and I absolutely fell in love with it. It was such a good book. You get so attached to the characters, and the plot line was just really good. So this whole series is about this dystopian future where everybody's split up into five factions, and each faction has a value. There's the Dauntless, who value bravery, the Abnegation, who value selflessness, then the Amity, who value peace, then there's the Erudite, who value knowledge, and then the Candor, who value honesty. Then you're raised in the faction that your parents are born in, and then at the age of 16, you take this sort of simulation test where it tells you what faction you're most suited for, and then after that there's a choosing ceremony where you get to choose to either stay in the faction you are born in, or you get to choose another faction to live in, except you can't live with your family anymore. And the government in this book has a saying called faction over blood, which basically means that you should go with what faction fits you best, more than being with your family. And this follows the story of a girl named Triss, who is at the age where she has to choose either to stay with her family or go into a different faction. And when she takes the simulation test, her results are apparently special, and she's different from other children. And it just follows the story of this main character and the journey she goes through. And one of the main things that she has to learn throughout these books is that each faction has like a downside to it. For example, the Amity, they're peaceful, but they're passive. And so she has to find a balance between all these factions while still choosing a faction to live in. And one quote from that to really describe the way she has to like balance the factions in her life is that there are so many ways to be brave in this world. Sometimes bravery involves laying down your life for someone bigger than yourself or for someone else. Sometimes it involves giving up everything you've ever known or everyone you've ever loved for the sake of something greater, but sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes it is nothing more than gritting your teeth through pain and the work of every day, the slow walk toward a better life. That is the sort of bravery I must have now. And I really like this book because you do become attached to the characters, and there are twists and turns every page, and you really don't know what to expect, and there's a lot of suspense, and I really like books like that. I'd recommend this book to anybody who liked The Hunger Games because it had a very similar feel to it with the whole dystopian novel type thing. It also follows a heroine who also is very independent and brave, just like Katniss is in The Hunger Games. And it is also a trilogy like The Hunger Games. So this overall was a great book, and I really enjoyed reading it.
Devin, what are you doing?
I'm practicing for the catwalk.
Actually, the catwalk is kind of different. Check out this video on the actual catwalk.
It's enough that I know our time had a home in your heart.
Creativity and the hard work, and I still can't believe they did it in 8 weeks. That's amazing. It looks like everybody put so much effort into it, and just what a great opportunity these girls have had to see what it's like to kind of do something like this. And I was thinking, as I was sitting there, that kind of exciting, they're going to be designing clothes for my store hopefully sometime. So that's wonderful. But as things like this happen, we do have to choose one with one winner, and we have. And her name is Helena Telson.
Come with me if you want to live.
Devin, what are you doing?
I'm just remaking some scenes from my favorite movies.
Why don't we check out an actual movie scene remake?
Are you going to teach us anything, or are we just going to sit here?
Just do whatever you want.
I want to learn from my teacher.
Besides that, Freddy, what do you like to do?
Burn stuff.
Just go out and have recess.
My parents don't spend $15,000 a year for recess.
What? You want to learn something?
Yes, I do.
You want to learn something? Want me to teach you something? Here's a useful lesson for you. Give up. Just quit. Because in this life, you can't win. Yeah, you can try. But you're gonna lose big time because the world is run by the man.
Who?
The man. Oh, you don't know the man? Well, he's everywhere. In the White House, down the hall, Miss Mullins, she's the man. And the man ruined the ozone, he's burning down the Amazon, and he kidnapped Shamu and put her in a chlorine tank, okay? There used to be a way to stick it to the man. It's called rock and roll. But guess what? Oh no, the man ruined that too with a little thing called MTV! So don't waste your time trying to make anything cool or pure or awesome, because the man's just gonna call you a fat, washed up loser and crush your soul. So do yourselves a favor and just give up! Oh.
Mr. Sheedley, it's after 10. On Tuesdays, the children have music class then?
Right. Good work, people. We'll continue our lecture on the man when we return. Have a good music class.